Hello friends, welcome to this video on areas of parallelograms and triangles. In the previous video, we learnt about the area of a triangle and a parallelogram located on the same base and between the same parallel lines. Today, we will solve some questions based on the same. Let us now look at a question. In the figure, KLMN is a rectangle and OPQR are the midpoints of sides KL, LM, MN and NK respectively. The area of quadrilateral OPQR is given as 36 square centimeter. Now, find the area of rectangle KLMN. Friends, before solving the question, can you tell what kind of a quadrilateral is quadrilateral OPQR? We have studied that the quadrilateral formed by joining the midpoints of a rectangle is a parallelogram. Therefore, quadrilateral OPQR is a parallelogram. And we have to find the area of rectangle KLMN. The area of a rectangle is equal to the product of its length and breadth. But we have not been given its dimensions. We can see that rectangle KLMN is made by combining these parts. So, its area will be obtained by adding the area of all these parts. We have information about the area of OPQR, but we do not have information about the area of these parts. If we draw a diagonal RP in the parallelogram OPQR, then two congruent triangles will be formed in this quadrilateral, triangle OPR and triangle PQR, which we can write in this way. You know that a diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles and the area of congruent shapes is equal. Therefore, the area of triangle PQR will be equal to the area of triangle OPR and it will be half the area of parallelogram OPQR. Thus, we get the area of these two triangles as 18 cm square. Friends, now if we look at quadrilateral KLPR, can you tell what kind of quadrilateral it is? Pause the video and think about it. Friends, this will also be a rectangle or let's say a parallelogram. It is given that KN is equal to LM and KN is parallel to LM because quadrilateral KLMN is a rectangle. R and P are the midpoints of KN and LM respectively. Therefore, KR is equal to LP and KR is parallel to LP. You can see that in quadrilateral KLPR, a pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. So, we can say that quadrilateral KLPR is a parallelogram. In quadrilateral KLMN, the two quadrilaterals formed by joining the midpoints of a pair of opposite sides will also be parallelograms. So, can we say that triangle OPR and parallelogram KLPR lie on the same base and between the same parallel lines? Yes. This means the area of triangle OPR is half the area of parallelogram KLPR. Or, let's say that the area of parallelogram KLPR is twice the area of triangle OPR. Hence, the area of quadrilateral KLPR is twice the area of the triangle OPR, which is 18 square centimeter, from which we will get the area of the parallelogram KLPR is equal to 36 square centimeter. Similarly, the area of parallelogram RPMN will also be 36 square centimeter. And these two consist of rectangle KLMN. And the area of quadrilateral KLMN will be equal to the sum of the area of quadrilateral KLPR and RPMN. Thus, we get the area of rectangle KLMN is 72 square centimeter. Now, let's look at another question. In the given figure, quadrilateral KLMN and quadrilateral OPMN are parallelograms. Quadrilateral OPMN has an area of 108 square centimeter. The length of sides KN and MN is 8 centimeter and 12 centimeter respectively. Find the area of triangle KLN. Pause the video and try to find the answer yourself. In the given figure, parallelogram KLMN and OPMN have the same base, side MN, and they both lie between the same parallel lines OL and MN. Therefore, the area of these two will be equal. The area of parallelogram OPMN is 108 square centimeter. This is given to us. Therefore, the area of parallelogram KLMN will also be 108 square centimeter. In triangle KLN, side KL measures 12 centimeter because its opposite side MN measures 12 centimeter in parallelogram KLMN. We have been given the measurement of side KN as 8 centimeter. If we state the area of triangle KLN as 48 cm square, then will it be correct? In the given figure, to apply the formula for the area of triangle 1 by 2 into base into height, we will need the measurement of its base and height. We have been given the measurements of base KL and side KN. But KN is not the height of the triangle because KN is not perpendicular. Let's see how to solve this problem without applying this formula. Look at the figure carefully. Triangle KLN and parallelogram KLMN lie on the same base KL and between the same parallel lines KL and MN. So, the area of triangle KLN will be half the area of parallelogram KLMN. We know that the area of parallelogram KLMN is 108 square centimeter. In this way, we will get the area of triangle KLN as 54 square centimeter. Friends, that's all in this session. We have solved some questions related to the area of triangle and parallelogram located on the same base and between the same parallel lines. We will discuss some more facts based on this in the next video. See you in the next video. Thank you.